Three things that you have to consider when deploying the main. One is the traveler line. Two is the main sheet, which is the red and white one. And then three is back here. So I was ready, my main sheet's ready, and now I want to look up at my sail. So I'm all set to go. I have the power on for my main, which is right here. So now I'm powered up back here. So there's two things that I look at back here. One is the in and out button on the side of the pedestal, and the other is the winch that I have to work. And if you look down here, you look at outhaul. Okay, so I take the outhaul out. Now, to pull the sail out, I need the winch, and I need the motor in the mainsail. So I want to wrap again. Again, three. One, two, three. Okay, now I can release my brake, and now I'm ready to pull that out and to go. I take my main, and this fast or slow, and I just let this fall on the floor, and now you can start watching. You'll see the blue triangle start working its way towards us, and I ease it out just very slowly, keeping a little bit of tension on the outhaul all the time so that it comes out nice and smooth. The outhaul goes a lot faster than the sail motor, so you kind of have to play with it a little bit, let some come out, pull it in. So we're going to deploy it all the way, and you'll see at the bottom of the sail, where it meets the boom, you'll see a black line coming up, and you'll also see at the top, you can see the on the other side the numbers for the sail. Otherwise, if you pull it all the way out and keep going with the motor, you start reversing the motor, and now you're going counterclockwise, and your buttons change. It's not a serious issue, but you've just changed your buttons. Now, okay. What we want to do is you want to have as little pressure on the sails as you can when you put it in. And what you and the key to this is having the traveler over to starboard all the way. So what you're seeing right now is you're seeing the pressure of the wind push the sail up against the starboard side of the mast. And what that section of mast does is it smooths it, goes across the face of the mast, into the mast in the furler, and winds it in clockwise. And then you have, for the most part, a nice smooth sail being left in your mast. Is you're gonna release the winch, but you're gonna hang on to it. You can see the pressure on that. I'm having to hold that. And what you wanna do is under control, furl. Not just letting this fly and letting it flop, because that way you're running into trouble of not having a smooth entry and jamming and things like that. So I'm going to keep pressure on there, not too much that you hear that motor start to whine in the mast, but enough to allow it to go. And now I go. And now I'm just letting this go over my hand and into the mast. What you want to do is you want to pull it right in so you don't see any white.